The following is a non-profit fan-made version of the original radio program, The Shadow. All sound effects have been found on YouTube and voices on castingcall.club.
Please support the official release. Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men? The Shadow knows.
Once again, we present to you the thrilling adventures of The Shadow. The hard and relentless fight of one man against the forces of evil. These dramatizations are designed to demonstrate forcibly to old and young alike that crime does not pay. The Shadow, who aids the forces of law and order, is in reality Lamont Cranston, wealthy young man about town. Years ago in the Orient, Cranston learned a strange and mysterious secret, the hypnotic power to cloud men's minds so they cannot see him. Cranston's friend and companion, the lovely Margot Lane, is the only person who knows to whom the voice of the invisible shadow belongs. This month's second episode, Death Goes Fishing. It is early one bright morning, and we find Lamont Cranston and Margot Lane in a rowboat fishing. That is, Lamont is fishing. Margot is just along for the ride.
What a beautiful day for fish.
Where are they, Lamont?
Who?
The fish. Aren't they supposed to catch themselves on the hook?
They will, Margot. Just give them time.
But we've been sitting out here for more than an hour, and...
Why, Margot, what's the matter? You look green.
Ugh, I feel green. The water won't stand still for a minute.
But why didn't you tell me you felt sick?
I was trying to be very brave.
Oh, you poor kid. I'll pull my line in and we'll go back to shore.
Thanks, Lamont.
I'll have it up in a... Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
I've got a bite.
Can't you shake it loose? Oh, I don't think I'd like to see a fish right now.
It feels like a whale. The way the rod is bent.
Would you mind if I didn't?
I'll have to use plenty of skill with this one. A few more seconds, Margot, and we'll have him. Hold everything.
I'm trying to.
There he goes. Breaking water. What a... Good Lord.
What's the matter, Lamont?
Don't look, Margot.
It's a body! It's the body of a man!
Cardona, get that crowd away from the body and let the coroner get through with his job. This is no vaudeville show.
Yes, sir. Come on, break it up. You people are in the way. Come on.
You fished that guy out of the water, eh, Cranston?
Yes, Commissioner.
It was the most horrible experience I ever had.
Well, it's not going to be pleasant for the guy that did it either. Come on. I want to look at the body. Well, Cardona, how are you coming?
The coroner's finished. He says the guy was killed by two bullets in the back of the neck.
I can see that for myself. How long has he been dead?
About 2 days.
2 days, huh? Did you check him for the identification?
No, sir. I thought you might want to do that yourself.
Okay. Stand by, Cardona, and make a list. Let's see. Chewing gum? Cigarettes?
Cigarettes?
Toothpicks?
Toothpicks.
That's all in this pocket. Nothing in the other. Now the inside coat pocket. Hey, what's this?
Why, it's a dead fish! How did it get into an inside pocket?
Probably swam in looking for food. It couldn't get out and died. Here, Cardona, throw it back into the water.
Yes, sir.
Here's what I'm looking for. An identification card. Hey, this is a press card.
Then he must have been a newspaper man.
That's right, Cranston. But who? 2 days in the water has taken all the writing off this card.
Have there been any inquiries about a missing newspaper man?
What? Of course! I got a call just yesterday from Cal Foster's family.
Cal Foster, the Daily Register reporter.
Yeah, know him?
He was a byline writer who stuck his nose into other people's business. He came out with good stuff at times. You know, Commissioner.
Yeah.
This is the body of Cal Foster. He must have been working on a story somebody didn't want published.
Mr. Meredith, do you recognize this picture?
Why, of course. That's Cal Foster. But, Commissioner, he looks dead.
He is. Murdered. These two people, Cranston and Miss Lane, fished him out of the bay this morning.
Murdered, eh? Commissioner, I want you to get whoever did this, and I don't want you to lose a minute.
That's what I'm getting paid for, Mr.
Meredith. I want action. I'll post a reward of $5,000.
Good. Now I want you to tell me what Foster was working on.
Well, he came to me some time ago and said he wanted to write a series of articles exposing gangs and rackets.
Which gangs and which rackets?
I don't know. Hale never talked about what he was going to write until he was ready to write it.
But you were his editor. When did he talk to you?
Commissioner, he was my ace reporter, and I gave him his head.
Mr. Meredith, do you know if Foster had any notes?
He most likely did, Mr. Cranston.
But I'm afraid I wouldn't know where. I haven't seen Kale since he began that assignment. He thought it'd be best to stay away from the office.
He probably didn't want to be identified as a newspaper man.
But he was, and somebody killed him. Meredith, did he ever tell you by phone what he was doing?
No. When Foster was ready to write a story, he wrote it. That's what he was getting paid for.
Well, Of all the... What am I going to do now? Cross-examine a corpse?
Mr. Meredith.
Miss Brewster, I'm busy
at... I must talk to you. I just heard a rumor about Cal. Is it true?
Who are you, miss?
I'm Anne Brewster. I write the woman's column for this newspaper. Cal Foster and I were engaged to be married. Is there anything else you'd like to know?
A couple of things.
Is that so? And just who are you?
I'm Police Commissioner Weston.
Police? Then it's true! Cal is dead!
He was murdered, Anne.
No! No! Cal! Oh, Cal! We were going to be married as soon as he finished the story. We were going to spend our honeymoon away from the city and everything. We had such plans. And now... Cal... Cal! Lamont, I can't stand it.
Easy, Margot.
Miss Brewster, I don't like to question you at a time like this, but my duty...
Yes, Commissioner, it's mine too. Fire away.
Do you know what Foster was working on?
Yes. He was getting material for a story about Tony Patrini, the gang leader, and Lon Caldwell.
The nightclub owner?
Yes. Cal told me he was about to break the story. That was 3 days ago. The last time I saw him.
Did he tell you what the story was about?
No. But he said it would be the biggest thing that ever hit this town.
Miss Brewster, are you sure he mentioned Lon Caldwell?
He went further than that. He said Patrini and Caldwell were working together.
But Caldwell's the most reputable nightclub owner in the town. I know him personally.
But Cal knew him intimately, and it cost him his life. Well, I'm not marking it 30. Caldwell and Patrini are going to pay for it, and I'm going to see that they do.
Miss Brewster, don't do anything you'll be sorry for.
Anything I do to those murderers, I'll never be sorry for.
Well, you better let the law run its course. Well, that'll be all for the moment. Goodbye, Mr. Meredith. Miss Brewster, and remember what I said.
Goodbye, Commissioner Weston.
After you, Cranston. Miss Lane.
Thank you.
Commissioner, I can't believe Lon Caldwell.
Well, I'm certain about Patrini.
Are we going to see him now?
I am. You and Cranston go home and get some rest.
But we don't need it, Commissioner.
I said go home. Patrini is a tough customer. If he thinks we know more than we should, he'll start shooting. And I don't want you kids around.
But Commissioner...
This is a police job, Miss Lane. And I want only policemen there. Goodbye. Give me a call at headquarters tomorrow.
Lamont, I think he's just being mean.
Not Weston, but come on. We're going to do some visiting of our own.
Where?
Cal Foster's apartment. If his notes are there, they may tell us why he was dangerous enough to kill. Well, Margot, nothing's here. Foster's desk is a total blank.
Have you looked in every drawer, Lamont?
Yes.
Then come over here and unlock this liquor cabinet. Cal Foster never impressed me as the kind of man who would keep his liquor locked up.
Of course. The notes are in there. Here, let me get at that lock with this penknife.
Why not just break the door?
I don't have to. This lock is a cinch. See? There it goes now.
There are the papers!
Yes. Now to do a little reading. Well, where do we start?
The beginning's always a good place.
When there's a page one. These pages aren't even numbered. We've got to get these papers in order before we can make any sense out of them.
Lamont, look! There! In the middle of that page.
The names of Patrini and Caldwell.
What does it say about them?
Engage in a racket of international scoop.
Does he say what kind of racket?
Not here. Gotta find the page that follows it.
Lamont, you dropped one of the papers.
Yes, looks like a memo.
I'll get it. Lamont, it has a name and an address on it. Winnie Roberts, Bayside. Bayside? That's a suburb, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
A woman in the case. A woman Foster told nobody about. Not even Anne Brewster, his fiancée.
Uh-huh.
A woman in the case. a woman Foster told nobody about. Not even Anne Brewster, his fiancée.
Mm-hmm.
Lamont, I'll bet Winnie Roberts is the key to this whole case.
Uh-huh.
Lamont!
Oh, what?
You didn't hear a word I said.
I'm sorry, Pet, but I was reading a carbon copy of Cal Foster's first installment about the racket he was investigating.
What? Then the story was ready for publication?
Yes, and that's why he was murdered.
What does he say in the first installment?
Nothing. It was just a teaser to get the public interested in what's to come later.
He doesn't mention the racket at all?
Not a word. The only references here is to a fishing expedition that should startle the nation when revealed.
A fishing expedition? Lamont! That fish we found in Cal Foster's pocket!
What about it?
Do you think?
No, that was just a freak. Cal Foster couldn't have meant anything by fishing expedition. It's a common expression.
Then let's find out what he meant by it.
All right, I'm sure the answer's in these notes. We'll start getting them in order.
Don't waste your time!
Lamont! A man with a gun?
Yeah, and I don't advise you to move.
What do you want?
Those papers in your hand. Put them on the table.
They don't belong to you.
Put them on the table. We'll discuss formalities in another time.
I think you better do as he says, Lamont.
All right. They're on the table. Now what?
Now thanks. I'll just pick them up and stuff them in my pocket.
Are you Mr. Patrini?
You just talked out of turn, lady. I don't like to be recognized.
Is that a crime?
It means I've got to kill you. Both of you.
Killing us won't do any good.
No.
The police know all about you and the murder of Cal Foster.
They don't know nothing.
This very moment, every cop on the force is looking for you.
Well, they'll never catch me through you. Hey, get away from that door.
It's not the door I want, Patrini.
Hey, turn those lights on.
Try to find us in the dark. Get down, Margot. I'm going for him.
You dirty, double-crossing rat!
He's gone. Margot, I'm going after... Margot, did you fall? Margot!
Oh...
The Shadow will return after this quick message. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure you check out our Facebook page for updates on future episodes. And if you have any questions about the program or wish to help voice a character for a future episode, feel free to leave us a message and we will reply as soon as we can. We pick up our story immediately after Patrini fired the two shots. We heard Margot groan and a body fall.
Where's that light switch? Margot.
Oh, my head.
Your head? But...
No, that monster didn't shoot me. You told me to get down, and I did, with all my force. I hit my head on this table.
Oh, you poor kid. Here, let me help you up.
Thanks. Whew, what an experience. But where is he? Did he get away?
I'm afraid so, but he won't get very far. Weston will pick him up. What do we do now?
Lamont, I think we ought to concentrate on Winnie Roberts.
You might have something there. We know Patrini killed Foster.
But we don't know why. And Winnie may be able to tell us.
If she's in the talking mood.
Well, why don't we go back to Bayside and find out?
Wait a minute. That may not be necessary. According to Cal Foster's notes, Patrini and Lon Cadwell, the nightclub owner, were in a racket together. Winnie Roberts could be an entertainer for Cadwell's club.
That's right, she could.
And she could be the liaison between Cadwell and Patrini.
Of course! Cadwell's respectability wouldn't allow him to be seen with a character like Patrini.
Margot, let's run over to Cadwell's nightclub and see if we can get Winnie Roberts to sing.
Ah, good evening, Monsieur Cranston, Mademoiselle Lane.
Hello, Henri.
Mademoiselle Lane is lovely tonight.
Thank you.
I have a wonderful table for you. Just in the right place for complete enjoyment of the show. Step this way.
No, Henri, we're not staying.
Oh, no, but why?
As a matter of fact, we only stopped in to see Winnie Roberts.
Winnie Roberts? Is it a reservation?
No, it's an entertainer in this show.
In this? But Mademoiselle Lane, there's no such lady in our show.
Are you sure?
How could that be? As a wise, I know every charming lady employed in this establishment. And they are all charming.
I see. I suppose we say hello to Lon Cadwell.
Of course. He would be pleased to see you as usual. You'll find him in the office.
Thanks.
Well, Lamont, I guess we came to the wrong place.
Maybe. But we could still see Cadwell and find out how he reacts when we mention Winnie Roberts. This is his office here.
Suppose he doesn't react. Suppose he's too smart.
You mean, suppose Cadwell's flown the coop? Come on, we're going in.
Lamont?
Close the door, quick.
Is he dead?
Yes. Two bullet holes in the back of his neck.
All right, Henri, all right. Never mind hysterics.
But Commissioner, who could have done such a horrible thing to Monsieur Cardwell?
The same guy that did it to Cal Foster. Now, you said you didn't leave the premises all evening.
Oui, Monsieur.
How come you didn't hear any shots?
But I have told you it is possible Monsieur Cardwell was killed while the orchestra was playing.
That's a sloppy excuse. You're shielding somebody who?
I do not lie, Monsieur.
No. And you didn't see anybody going into this office either.
I did not say that.
What?
You did not ask me that question before. A very excited young lady asked me where to find Monsieur Cardwell. I told her and she marched directly into his office.
Why, Commissioner, that sounds like it might have been Aunt Brewster, the girl Cal Foster was going to marry.
Yeah, she did say she was going to get revenge, Cardona. Send out an alarm for Aunt Brewster, a columnist, for the Daily Register. Do it right away.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Commissioner.
What, Cranston?
Where does that back door lead to?
I can explain, gentlemen. Monsieur Cardwell used it as a private entrance. That door leads to a driveway.
Then, isn't it possible, Commissioner, that whoever killed Cardwell came in by that back door?
Are you trying to tell me Ann Brewster had nothing to do with this?
Well, Cardwell was shot twice in the back of his neck.
Coincidence. Nothing else.
Lamont?
What?
I must talk to you right away.
What about?
Not here. Let's go outside.
But Margot.
Please, I've got a theory. Let's go out the back way. It's quicker.
All right. But your theory had better be good.
Let's walk around to the back of the club. I don't want anybody to listen.
Margot, if you're building me up to a terrific letdown...
Lamont, what I've got in mind is sensational.
Then tell me about it, please.
Where are we now?
Near the delivery entrance to the club.
Is anybody in that truck over there?
Yes, the driver. Margot, will you please just tell me?
All right, listen. Winnie Roberts and Ann Brewster are one and the same person.
What?
I haven't any proof, Lamont, but everything points to it.
Now, wait a minute, Margot. Do you realize what you're saying?
Yes, that Ann Brewster killed Cal Foster, and I don't believe she and Foster were going to be married.
But why? Why should she have killed him?
Because, as Winnie Roberts, she was mixed up in this racket he was investigating, and she was afraid he'd find out who Winnie Roberts really was. It makes sense, doesn't it?
I don't. Look out, Margot. Let that truck pass.
Well, what do you think?
Margot, did you smell anything as that truck passed by?
Yes, I smelled fish.
Ugh, kick me hard. The world's number one idiot.
Why? What's the matter?
We've got no time to talk. Let's get into the street. We're going for a drive.
Where to?
On a fishing expedition of our own.
Why, Lamont, this is the Bayside Ocean Club.
Uh-huh. Let's get up.
Do you think Winnie Roberts lives here?
I'm sure of it. Come on, let's take a hike down to the shore.
But Lamont, why the shore? Why not?
Because I got a theory too. Winnie Roberts may not be the name of a woman after all.
What? What do you mean?
I think Winnie Roberts is the name of a boat.
Lamont, have you gone berserk?
Maybe. Oh, there's a rowboat. Step in. We're going out to sea.
I'm going against my better judgment.
There are some boats anchored in the bay. One of them may be the Winnie Roberts.
But suppose Winnie Roberts is the name of the boat. What does it mean? And what has it got to do with fish?
We fished Cal Foster's body out of the bay. That could mean that Foster was murdered on board a boat, and his body dropped overboard.
I repeat, what has that to do with fish?
We found a fish in Foster's pocket. Well, it begins to look to me as though as the fish didn't swim into that pocket. Foster himself put it there, without the murderer's knowledge. And I think he intended to save it as evidence. Margot, look over there.
Where? A yacht! With the name Winnie Roberts painted on it.
I'm going to maneuver this boat over to that ladder, and we're going to go aboard. Okay, I'll grab the ladder. Doesn't seem to be anyone on board. No lights. We're not taking any chances. I'll climb up first. You follow.
All right, Lamont. I'm right behind you.
Watch your step. Don't let your foot slide.
Don't worry. I'll be very careful.
Okay, I'm at the top.
Is anybody on deck?
Yes, one man. But he's asleep in a chair. Easy now, we don't want to wake him up. All right, I'm on deck. I'll help you. Easy. Don't jump. Huh, perfect landing.
We're here, Lamont. What now?
Down that companionway. Walk on your toes. Shh. We're going below.
There's that fish smell again.
Yes, we gotta find out where it comes from.
There's only one thing to do. Follow our noses.
It seems to be coming from that direction.
Say, this yacht must be really luxurious. Thick plush carpet on the floor.
I don't know who might be on board.
But you said there were no lights.
That doesn't mean a thing.
Phew. That fish smell is awful.
It seems to be coming from this room. I'm gonna try the door.
Oh, my goodness. That smell. I can't stand it.
Come on, there's a few steps here leading down to the hold. Be careful. It's quite dark.
How can anybody live with a smell like this?
Hold that handkerchief over your nose.
I am.
Holy smoke.
What?
Look at these barrels of dead fish.
Do I have to look at them too? Lamont, what are you doing with that fish?
Here, hold this flashlight. I'm gonna cut it open.
All right. As long as you don't ask me to hold the fish.
There. Look at this.
Why, it's a small package. Did that come out of the fish?
Yes. Let's see what's in this package.
Lamont, it's a white powder.
Slightly more than that, Margot. This white powder is a narcotic. And that means Foster was killed because he was about to expose a gigantic and cleverly operated narcotic racket.
So that's what he meant by a fishing expedition that would startle the nation.
That's right. Poor fellow.
What was that?
Sounds like the engines.
Lamont, we're...
Yes, Margot. We're moving.
Lamont, if we ever get off this boat with a whole skin, I'll...
No conversation. There are staterooms on both sides of this corridor. They may be occupied.
All right. No more. Listen.
Voices. They're coming from that stateroom. Let's find out who they belong to.
You'll do nothing of the kind, Patrini! Let me go!
You're not behind a newspaper writing a column now, Ann Brewster. And those bells on deck don't mean it's quitting time.
You're just a four-flusher, Patrini. You wouldn't dare hurt me.
Two things you just said I don't like. I don't like being called four-flusher, and I don't like being dead.
Well?
You know too much, sister, and you talk too much. We don't consider it safe having you floating around, except in the bay.
I'll do a lot more talking when I get out of here.
You're a fool, Anne.
Lamont, that's Sam Meredith, the editor of the Daily Register.
Yes, Margot.
Patrini's going to kill both of them.
Not if I can help it. You find a safe place to hide. I'm going into this room as the shadow.
Okay, sister. This is it.
Mr. Meredith, are you going to let him kill me?
What can I do, Miss Brewster?
Stop him! Tell him to put down that gun!
You think he'll take orders from me? You forget. I'm as much a prisoner as
That's
you.
That's a lie! This boat is yours! You betrayed me into coming aboard. You said you had information that would lead me to the murder of Cal Foster. You're his murderer. You and Patrini.
Patrini, make her stop talking. Please.
With pleasure. Hey! Somebody knocked the gun out of my hand! Who is it?
Stay where you are, Patrini. You too, Meredith.
The Shadow!
Yes, Miss Brewster. Pick up that gun, please. Sam Meredith, what have you got to say for yourself?
You sound like a judge about to pass sentence of death.
Which you justly deserve. You, as the mastermind and boss of a racket, an international disease, have ruined the lives of thousands of foolish men and women. And you, Patrini.
No! I didn't do nothing! I was working for him! He gave me the orders.
You killed Carl Foster and Long Cadwell.
No, I ain't taking that rep for nobody. Meredith did it.
Shut up, Patrini.
I'll tell him. I'll stand up against anybody, but not the Shadow. Meredith found out what Foster knew about that narcotics racket, so he got Foster on this boat and killed him.
I want proof, Patrini.
Look in the top drawer of this desk. There's a gun in there.
Patrini, I'll kill you for
Get
this.
Get back, Meredith. Patrini, tell me about this gun.
That's the rod that killed Foster and Caldwell. It belongs to Meredith. The cops should check those bullets they took out of those guys. They'll see where those bullets came from.
And would you advise the police to check this gun for fingerprints too?
Yeah, Meredith's prints are all over it.
You swine! You dirty, filthy swine! I'll kill you!
Get him off me, Shadow! He's choking me!
My hands! Let go of my hands, you invisible monster! You're paralyzing
they
them!
They should have been paralyzed before you came a murderer.
Well, Margot, I suppose you want to know all the details of those murders and that filthy narcotic racket.
If you don't mind, Lamont.
Sam Meredith planned it and ran it behind a screen of journalistic dignity. All narcotics leads were directed to him.
Where did Lon Caldwell come in?
As an outlet and a front. As a nightclub owner, he could receive shipments of fish without arousing suspicion. The fish containing the narcotics were then sent all over the world.
And I suppose Patrini's job was to take care of the distribution. But why was Caldwell killed?
After Cal Foster found out what was going on, Sam Meredith had to protect himself. He killed Foster first, disposed of his body. But when we fished him out of bay, he decided to cover himself completely by getting rid of his two partners. He intended to kill Patrini, too.
But what I don't understand is why did Meredith allow Foster to do an undercover job on rackets in the first place?
You never dreamed that Foster would find out about the narcotics racket, which was concealed inside dead fish.
But how did he find out that Foster knew about it?
Remember that carbon copy of the first installment we found among Foster's papers?
Yes.
Well, where was the original? Foster must have given it to Meredith, his editor. And by doing that, he unknowingly signed his own death warrant.
Lamont, that's the most ironical thing I've ever heard of.
Here's something just as ironical. Cal Foster's story will be published and he will go down in newspaper history as a hero. But the nicest thing that can ever be said about Patrini and Meredith will be died in the electric chair.
The Shadow Program is based on a story copyrighted by Street & Smith Publications. The characters, names, places, and plot are fictitious. Any similarity to persons living or dead is purely coincidental. Again, next month, The Shadow will demonstrate that
the weed of crime bears its bitter fruit. For crime does not pay, The Shadow knows.
Next month, we will bring you yet another strange and thrilling adventure in the Shadow's daring battle against the forces of evil. Be sure to listen, like our Facebook page, and subscribe to this YouTube channel.